And good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Mitchell Gymnasium here at Bishop's University. As tonight we bring you a matchup between the Lady Gaiters and the Laval Rouge AOR. My name is Jeff Perino, joined here by my partner, Robbie Finley. Thank you for joining us here on SSN Canada as the two teams are introducing their starters. So tonight, starting for the Laval Rouge AOR, who do we have here, Robbie?
We got Marjorie Ferland. She's the starting point guard for the Laval. We also have Elise Aubin, Mary-Michelle Genois, Melody Lenal Dion, and Mary-Pascal Nadeau, starting at center.
And as we see here, the Lady Gaiters getting ready to take the court. We have starting for your Gaiters tonight, Caddy Germain, Gabrielle Chevron, Jesse Bois, Melanie Roulette-Gotchow, and Bailey Trafford. An interesting note there, Trafford's getting one of her first starts of the regular season. She's seen some time coming off the bench, and also she started a few games over the break, I understand. And the first year has really just excelled in the position that she's taken.
I think that's right. You got that right there. This Bishop's women's team, their strength is at the guard position, and their posts are looking for whatever works right now, Jeff. And she's playing the best right now, and Pernell rewards her with a start tonight. Set for the opening tip here.
And as Laval takes it here, the Gaiters' only regular season win this year is against Laval Rouge AOR, when Gabrielle Chamberlain put up 20 points. Ball goes out to the point there, now down low. Back out to the top to number 4, Ferland. Ferland misses the shot, and good rebound there by Watt, as Watt takes it down the court for the Gaiters. Roulette-Gotchow puts it up for 3 and misses it on the outside rim. Collected there by the Rouge AOR. Good defense there by Caddy Germain. Steals the ball right down to Chamberlain, and she tosses up, misses the layup. Rebounded there by Ferland. Back out to number 6, Jolvin. Back out to the top, far side, Lenal Dion. Back over to Jolvin. Jolvin pulls up, toss out to the outside. Genois now has it down low to number 15, Nadeau. Goes up for the shot and gets fouled.
Interesting start here for the Gaiters. They actually don't have a true post in the game right now. That's Laval's strength, is their post play. But they went into a zone early and working pretty effectively, actually. Laval struggled to really create a good shot for themselves.
She won't be going to the line. It'll be a throw-in here now for Ferland. Back out to the top there to Genois. Back to the top of the key. As we see number 12 there, drive it down low. Passes it over to Genois, and she puts the first bucket up on the board.
That's the downside of playing small. Genois, she's a really tall girl. No one, Bishops can't match up with her height, and they're going to have to find a way to stop that.
The wall drives down to the rim. Tipped there and stolen. Genois now has it for Laval. Held there by Jolvin. Back over to Ferland. Nadeau drives back over to Genois. She goes up and is fouled.
Foul on Caddy Germain. There looks like she got called for the reach in. Actually, from our angle, it sounded like all ball, but obviously the ref disagreed with us.
Looked to be the referee called that. There was a bit of a difficult angle to grab that call, actually. But definitely saw a reach in Germain's feet might not have been planted on that play.
A lot of the times the ref just looks for the motion of the hand coming down. Whether you get the ball or not, 8 times out of 10, ref's going to call that.
And Genois drains the 2 out of a single there. And a lot of brings up for the Gaiters. Back over to Chamberlain. Down to the far side, tipped out by Genois. Genois using that reach to her advantage so far. His measure is in at 6'2".
Yeah, like I said, Bishops is the tallest player on the floors right now. Is only 5'9", so they're really going to have some problems matching up with her. We'll see how they react.
Germain drives, tosses up a difficult 2, and rebounded by Chauvin, recovered by Laval. Hard defense there by Waugh. Ooh, that got terrible challenging and stolen there by Chamberlain.
Great help side defense there by Chamberlain. Comes over from the weak side and picks up the pass off.
Swing pass over to Germain. She fakes the shot and goes down low and stolen there by Genoa. Once again, using her great reach. Genoa now drives to the basket, tosses it up for two. Great little spin move. Gets her own rebound and puts it in for two.
Pretty move by Genoa there. She's got all six of Laval's points. Gators really need to make an adjustment on her.
And a big stop there by Nadal Laval. Bailey Trafford had all types of time underneath the net, and Adele came back just to give her a little bit more of her Christmas stuff.
Maybe didn't get enough of that over the break.
Well, the matchup here between the two bottom teams of the conference, both only have one win. The Gators have a record of 1-6, while Laval's record of 1-5.
Yeah, this is a really important game for both teams. If you want to make the playoffs, you got to win these tight ones against the two bottom feeder teams there, Jeff.
Let Gotchar drives to the basket there, and good effort to grab the foul, and she'll be going to the line for two. 5-0 lead here for Laval.
One thing about playing so small, it forces Genoa to go out and cover our guard on the perimeter where maybe she's not used to covering, so see if Bishops can take advantage of that.
Cote Kawat now into the game for Caddy Germain. A big rebound there by Jesse Wallace. That Godchild missed for second of two. And another missed layup for the Gators. Catherine Belanger-Paquette missed a bit of an easy layup there. And if the Gators want to keep in this game, they're going to want to really hit those ones.
Yeah, those are the easy ones. You can't miss those. Those are
strong defense there by the Gators, and a huge pass down court to Cote Kawak. Cote dribbles down low, but about three Laval Rouge or players there all over.
Yeah, she's just got to go up strong with that ball.
Travel called there underneath the basket on Nadeau. That'll be a Gators ball.
Gators are fortunate there. The Laval's really using their height advantage with Nadeau and Genoa both listening in at 6-2. They're just throwing the ball up and they're coming down with it pretty easily. See if Coach Perrin will make any adjustments in the next coming minutes.
The tallest player on the court for the Gators right now is Bailey Trafford, who is at 6'11". And a big three there! That was 21. Melanie with that Godchild putting more points on the board for the Gators. And another pass down low. And that was number 9, Jen Wall getting another pass.
Yeah, I think the Gators have been switching up between zone and man. And half the girls didn't know what they were in there. And unfortunately left Jen Wall wide open underneath the hoop for an easy two.
Rebound there for Trafford as the Gators take over possession. 7-4 lead here for Laval. 6 minutes left in the first, and a travel called by Jesse Watt. Looks like she ran before she got the ball there, Robbie.
Yeah, it took a couple steps before she put it on the floor. Easy call from the official. Here comes number 15, Dana Janvier for the Bishops Gators. Finally, Coach Bernal puts in a little hype to combat Genoa and Nadeau at the low post.
Janvier has got great defensive talent, and we see it already. Just a hustle player, heart and soul. Drive down low. And great defense there by Gabrielle Cote-Calette.
Good help side by Gab there. Lucky she didn't get called for the foul, and unfortunately she stepped out of bounds, but good defense.
Just hard defense that we see by the Gators. Definitely defense not lacking right now.
No, they're playing incredibly spirited, I guess you could say, Jeff, but just a couple of mental breakdowns on the fast break, giving Genoa just easy layups. So those are killers, especially when you're playing good defense for the remainder possessions.
Genoa down low, tosses up, misses the original shot, but rebounded by number 5, Andrews Cote of Laval. Genoa has it over the top, and Genoa is definitely looking like their go-to player. And good defense there by the Gators as they recover. Cote Kawat driving to the basket. She has out on the top of the key. Now over to Waugh. Back over to Belanger-Paquette. Down low. It's going to be off her fingertips and out. Laval ball. see Laval going to their bench here now as Genois is going to have a few minutes to rest.
That's well-deserved there, Genois. I think she might have had all seven of the Laval's points there. She was outstanding in that first quarter.
And Riley Shkimba now checking into the game for the Gaiters. Maybe playing a little match there, matching the changes there as we saw Laval go right to the bench.
Yeah, speaking to the Gators' assistant coaches, I think they really think they have an advantage at the guard position, so they're really looking to take advantage of that, especially when Genmog gets out of the game.
More strong defense by the Gators, they force another turnover, and they'll take over in Laval territory. Shkimba back over to Janvier. Janvier has it at the top. They're going to want to get her down low. Passes over to Wall. Wall makes a great drive up. No foul called there. She put the ball up. Wall now takes over again as she looks to go up. Another awkward looking layup as the shot clock is ticking down. The Gators are going to want to take smarter shots than that if they want to get
that.
Once again, we see Hart Diaz. Janvier takes over the ball.
Gators' transition defense has really been poor here in this first 5 minutes. Their half-court defense has been great, but they really haven't been getting back. And their post, Laval's posts are just getting easy looks at the basket.
Those passes are cutting through the Gators' defense, as you said. They're not recovering fast enough, and it's just cutting through their defense like a knife through butter. Over to the post, the Wall. Down low, Janvier. Missed there, but recovered by Cote Calvet. She's going to drive to the net. Draws the foul call there. And it will be going against Laval.
Good take by Gab there. She put some pressure on the defense. Instead of settling for a jump shot, she took it right at the basket and able to get a foul call. Gator shooting a dismal 1-for-7 here in the first... 6 minutes, Jeff. That's not going to cut it if they want to win this game. They got to put the basket ball in the basket. Excuse me.
Only 4 points so far, and we're over halfway through the first quarter.
Both teams going to their benches early. Probably just want to keep their legs fresh. I know Gators play a game tomorrow night too, so you're not just thinking that tonight, although it's the most important one. But keep them fresh, and if you're playing well, ride them out.
Exactly. When we see the pass in here, Shkimba looks to inbound the ball. Back over to Boulanger Paquette. To the top to Cote Calvet. Annette Gachal drives to the net.
Bit of a rush pass there by Nick. She didn't really have anyone open and caught herself in the air with the ball and had to throw a turnover.
See Laval take over now. Chapadeau drives to the net and she uses her height, tosses up an awkward looking shot but doesn't fall. Another great defense there. Charles takes over the ball for the Gators and they recover the ball.
Great hustle by Nick, getting on the floor, getting a loose ball.
Cote Calvet tosses up a three, just misses off the back. Got a dead ball foul, it looks like.
Looks like Janvier, I think she might have gave her a little shove underneath the basket going for that rebound. You can't be too mad with that, though. She was working hard for the rebound. Unfortunate, but those fouls happen.
There's one thing you can never really take away from Janvier is definitely just how hard she tries day in, day out.
She's one of the hardest workers on this team, I know, and coach has got to love that defensive presence that she brings to the game, too.
Driving to the net now is 12 for Laval. Lenal de Dignon.
Another good defensive possession by the Gators. If they had not had those lapses on the fast breaks, they could be winning this game despite the score of only 7-4. Both teams shooting terribly. Laval 3-for-9 and Bishop's 1-for-8. So it's anybody's game right now, Jeff.
The height difference is just outstanding right now. Laval's towering over Bishop's, and Bishop's going to have to find a way to really use that to their advantage. Boulanger-Paquette has it for the Gaiters at the top. Passes it out to Charles. Charles puts it up off the front rim, but rebounded there by Bailey Trafford. Back out to the top to Charles. Down to the far side to Roulette-Gon Charles. She puts it down, though, up to Trafford. Trafford puts it up in a beautiful reverse layup.
Great possession by Trafford. She's the one that got him that extra possession and got rewarded after with the easy layup. I shouldn't say easy. That was a nice reverse over 6-2 Genoa. So
that's what they're going to need. Tricky layups like that to work. Gators take over now. Kotekawa has it down, though. Fumbling with the ball, but recovers. Charles has it now at the top. She drives down low, sees an opening, goes for the layup, misses it. Trafford misses the layup, and it's recovered there by Laval. Passes down to Genoa. Genoa looks to hurt her ankle on the play.
I think she might have just landed awkwardly on that ankle.
Some poor rebounding here by the Gators, as number 12, Lanel Dion, got about three rebounds in there and finally sunk it.
Talking to the coaches too about last week's loss to UCAM, they said rebounding was one of their biggest weakness, and tonight it's looking to be much the same. They're going to have to work on that if they want to win.
Another beautiful layup there as Kotekawa pulls the reverse under the hoop, and I guess that's how they're going to be getting around all this height, is the tricky layups under the rim. Mm-hmm.
The girls are actually able to use the rim as an advantage, so she comes in, Genoa's not able to get around and block her shot.
Ball goes out of play off of the fingertips of Ferland, and it will be a Bishop's throw in. Score 9-8 for Laval. 1:31 left in the first quarter. A low scoring affair so far.
It has. The defense for both sides has been good, but actually the offense for both sides has actually been pretty poor. The shooting is not there, but that can sometimes mean it's been good defense. So.
Beautiful three put up there, just off the back rim. Wide open look for Roulette-Gon Charles.
Good shot from Melanie there. She's a good three-point shooter. She's open. She's got to take that shot.
Ball up there for Laval as Jolbet missed an open jumper. Jesse Wan now drives all the way from coast to coast and puts it in for two. The Gators have taken their first lead of the game.
Beautiful take there by Jesse.
Genoa's got all sorts of time, a bit of a mismatch under the rim there.
I think she was a little surprised how open she was underneath the rim. Didn't really have to rush that one, but she did, and fortunate for the Gators. She missed it, and they're ball.
Laval's got three players that all are over 6 foot. As Julie Chapadeau, Mary Pascal Nadeau, as well as Marie-Michelle Genoa, are all 6'2". And that's just towering over the Gators right there. Stephanie in it. Shout puts it down low to Bailey Trafford. She puts it up for two. Great passing there, Robbie.
Beautiful passing, and she's just had a great first shift there. She's had a couple offensive rebounds, a defensive rebound, and two baskets. So she's been playing awesome.
Ball up to the top to Chapadeau. Stolen by Trafford. She's all over the court.
And had a steal of that now, Jeff.
Roulette-Gon Charles, pass it over to Wall. Coach Furneaux sets up his last second offense. He's going to look to sink one before the quarter expires. 3 seconds left. Over to Wall. She's going to have to put it up. Puts up a funny layup and misses. And that brings us to the end of the first quarter. And the score, Bishop's 12, Laval Rouge or 9.
Well, it was probably not the start the Gators won, but they really did close that quarter beautifully. A couple good, tough, awkward layups fell, gave maybe a little momentum, and got some great stops on defense against Genoa and Nadeau. Didn't let them get going underneath the hoop, so great start for the Gators. And for Laval, they had a great start, but they really started shooting poorly, especially after Genoa went off the court there for that first time. They seemed to hit a bit of a lull.
No doubt about that, Robin. It's really going to be an interesting match of how Bishops deals with the height, whereas on defense, they look to be okay right now, and they look to be figuring out how to really take Genoa out of the game and take some of the height from Laval out of the game.
Exactly. They're doing that beautifully in the half court, but in the full court transition. Jen Hua, even though she's tall, she can really run the floor well. And I think that's surprising, maybe a couple of the Gators, especially their posts. They need to realize that, hey, if Laval's got the ball, you got to get back on defense, because you know Jen Hua is going to be sitting there under the hoop waiting for the basketball.
No doubt about that. And as we said before, the only matchup between the two so far this season is Bishop's winning, with Gabrielle Chevron putting up 20 points in her first 20-point effort of her Bishop's career. You see the team's ready to get back onto the court. Bishop's looks ready to go. Laval's finishing up some final touches on their coaching there, as the head coach in her 26th season for Laval, Linda Marquet.
I know she's had a couple great seasons even since I've been here, but she's a legend around Quebec, and she does a great job with her girls every year. A little bit of a rough year, a rough start for them this year, but I expect them to always be in contention.
Well, definitely has a bit of a younger team. With really the majority of their players in the first and second year. Farlan now brings it in for Laval, and she's being called for an over and
a carry. It was Jeff, carry? I think that was the call. Yes, she palmed the ball. She kept the hand underneath the ball for too long and took an extra step with the basketball. Good pressure to start the game by the Gators. Start the quarter, excuse me.
And it will be Wall bringing it in, as she's really controlled the majority of the Gators scoring, but it's definitely been spread out of late. Wall drives all the way to the net, misses the layup. And Laval will take over now in a beautiful little behind-the-back dribble by Chauvin. Back over to Genois. Genois drives down low. Back out to the top, and Dole tosses up a three just off of the rim and out, and it will be Gators ball.
I think the Gators were here a little bit surprised at that. Nadal, she's a big center, didn't think that she had the shooting touch, but maybe you gotta have to watch her. She's gonna want to shoot those.
Looking like Chris Bosch tossing up the threes from when she's 6'2 in the center, but doing a good job of that. Chamberlain now has it and fakes a few times. Beautiful little move there, and she puts it in for two.
Beautiful one-on-one isolation there for Chamberlain. She took advantage. Oh,
and a great steal there. She hustles right back into the play. Good bounce pass over to Lacachao. Back to Chamberlain. They set up the offense. Wall drives down to the hoop. She puts it up and misses, but gets her own rebound. Chamberlain now is swinging around the outside. Back over to Caddy Germain. Back to Wall. And Wall's going to be called for the travel on that one. Her second travel of the night.
Yeah, she just looks to be picking up that back pivot foot before she puts the basketball down. Usually a little uncharacteristic. Usually she's pretty solid with the ball. So.
Chauvin takes it over for Laval. It'll be just off the hands of Laval.
Bishop's putting great ball pressure on the ball handlers, forcing the Laval Rougeor into 10 early turnovers. And that's a lot in 12 minutes of basketball.
And another turnover there. It's just off the tips of Kadijman. Then right back into the hands of Laval. Some sloppy play here. That ball's looking like a greased up watermelon out there.
A little disheartening for Bishop. They probably... Ooh. And a tough foul on the three-point shooter there by Jesse Waugh. Thought never to foul the jump shooter, but she did on that one. That's unfortunate. Three easy foul shots coming up.
Maybe a little frustration there by Waugh. She's had a few tight calls on her on those travels, and a few that have looked to be off of the other player's fingertip and called against her. But definitely Jesse Waugh, one of the veterans of this team. She's going to buckle down, and you can tell that she's going to be right back into this game. Definitely one of the leaders of this young Gators team.
Of course. She's been around fourth year now, and she's the point guard, usually entrusted into the captain position. And girls look to her when things are going down, and she's done a great job.
Jeanbin hits her first. She goes 3 for 3 on the line there.
Laval like shooting 4 for 5 from the free throw line. De Bishop's 1 for 2.
And that's something that you're going to have to watch. The Gators are going to foul a lot when you have such a high-tier, tall team underneath. And you're going to foul that team's going to have to be good to capitalize on those fouls. It looks like they have been so far. Germain down low to Chamberlain. Chamberlain tosses it up and just bounces off. A great rebound there by Germain. She hustles right back into the play. Back out to Wash. She tosses up off the rim. And another rebound there by Caddy Germain. Great hustle.
Two offensive rebounds for Germain. That's the kind of hustle plays that the Gators are looking for. Jessie called for another double dribble. Uncharacteristic turnovers for her.
Ball over to the number 10 of Laval, DeCruc. DeCruc back over to the far side to Genoa. Genoa out to the top. And an air ball there by Catherine Andrews-Cote.
There was great ball movement by Laval. Genoa recognized that she was doubled, found the open three-point shooter, but just weren't able to hit the ball, knock down the shot. Excuse me.
We have Juan now at the top of the key for the Gators.
Moving screen called on number 24, Bailey Trafford. Just got to be set when he set that screen, but she was shuffling her feet and got called for it.
Genoa inbounds the ball now to Jobin of Laval. Hard D here by Jesse Waugh. Full court pressure applied by Waugh. And some good dribbling to dribble out of that by Jobin. And a travel call there against Andrews-Cote.
Laval's 12th turnover of the game. Gators are just doing an excellent job of putting ball pressure on these point guards.
Germain over the far side. Chamberlain. Chamberlain's looking for a run. Underneath, all the way back out to Caddy Germain. Caddy Germain tosses it up for three. Just off the back. Gators looking a little shaky from three-point range right now, Robbie.
Yeah, they're only, they're 1-for-7 now from that three-point line, but these Bishops women's guards are good three-point shooters. I expect them to fall if they keep letting them fly.
Catherine Andrews-Cote drives to the net and fouled there by Wall, I believe. And it looks like it's time for some subs here for the Gators. It's almost a yard sale or a line change right there.
Getting some fresh legs in against these Laval players.
Looks like we have Trafford, Cote Cowette, Belanger Paquette, Riley Shkimba, and Henrik Stephanie Charo. A lot of the veterans off the floor here for the Gators. We'll see how these the bench players are doing for the Gators.
Yeah, I know Coach Perrin was such a young team. You're going to have to trust your first years at some point, and he's showing a lot of trust in them, having them start throughout the year, and they've responded, and they're getting better each game.
Ball almost goes through the hands there of Charles. Charles has it now, drives to the outside, off the hands of Genoa. And once again, we see that long reach of Genoa really coming to use. Marie-Michelle Genoa, the center, 6'2", in her fifth year, studying molecular biology, actually. See some of the smart girls out there. Definitely not the easiest course. Great pass there as Charles pushes up, and she gets two.
Great play set up off the inbound. A little back screen for a neck, and able to convert. Great pass from out of bounds by Paquette.
Looking like Tom Brady and Wes Welker out there with that pass.
Well, we'll see this weekend, Jeff, I guess.
And a quick two put up there by Elise Jobin of Laval. Ties the game up at 16 with 6 minutes left to play here in the first half. Cote Cowette makes a quick dribble, drives to the net, puts an awkward shot up there and blocked by Genoa.
See the height advantage come into play there on for Genoa. Gab did the right thing and tried to beat her off the dribble, but Genoa just a little too tall there and able to get her hand for an easy block.
Ball inbounded there as it goes back to Cote Cowette. Claire Murphy now into the game for the Gators. And shot clock runs out. Poor shot clock management there by the Gaiters.
Yeah, that one really hurts. You hate not to get at least a shot up at the basket. I know the bench was counting there. I don't think the girls on the court could hear, and obviously weren't aware of the time.
Definitely did not look like it was rushed at all. Now 21 now into the game. Yves Sophie Lefebvre out for Laval. Genois back over to the top. To Jobin. Back out, and another three tossed up there by Chapadeau, but recovered by Laval. Shot clock ticking down, and more poor short shot clock management there by Laval, as it's recovered by Riley Shkimba of Laval, of Bishop, sorry. All to the far side to Cote Cahuet. Makes a quick move. Good screen there by Janvier, as another reverse layup, and it drains. That's Cote Cahuet's second beautiful reverse layup of the night.
She's getting to the basket really easy tonight, and if she can continue making those shots, she's going to be really effective.
Ball put up there, and a foul against the Gaiters, and it will be Yves-Sophie Lefebvre, the first-year guard into the game for Laval. Gaiters absolutely with some of these layups, and the words of Ricky Bobby are using a little shake and bake tonight, Robbie.
Well, that's exactly it. They, the strong side on the layup might not be there because of the height of a Nadeau or a Genois, but they're able to come to the other side of the basket, and through a lot of practice, of course, they're able to put that ball in. Great job by the Gaiters.
The Fever goes 1-for-2 on foul shots, getting at an 18-17 Bishop's lead. Shkimba passes it over the far side to Murphy. Down low to Cote Cahuet. Another tricky layup tossed up there and misses.
There's a fine line between what she has been doing in that last one. That last one was a little wild, didn't really have a chance to go in.
Genois has it now for Laval. Down low, a beautiful little over-the-back pass. The out off of the hands of Sandri Ducouc of Laval.
Chamberlain back in the game, along with Melanie Gauchard.
Looks like Coach Pernod is really going into some of the veterans towards the end of the half. Maybe finish off with a strong drive, put a few more boards up there. Points on the board, sorry. It will be Jesse Wall at the top. Back over to Dana Janvier. Janvier called for travel on that one there. She took a step before she dribbled there, Robbie.
Great defense by Chapadeau. She really read where Dana was going on that play and just stood there, and Dana had no option but to take a couple steps before she put the ball on the ground.
It looked like Janvier wasn't really expecting anybody to be there.
More ball pressure here by the Gaiters.
Good job there by Claire Murphy, the Gaiters. And Nadeau push called there against Janvier, as she looked to be trying to put as much pressure as she could on Nadeau of Laval. Just maybe a little too much.
That's definitely a downside sometimes when you're playing so aggressively that sometimes you get a little overactive, and she gave her a little push on that. But again, I think the coaches are going to be able to live with that. Although Laval Rouget are now in the penalty, starting pretty early, 4 minutes. So every time Bishop's fouling, Laval's going to the line.
It's definitely can be a bit of a backbreaker, especially as we've seen Laval's excellent shooting from the top and for the free throws.
Yeah, they have just been shooting excellent.
It'll be Nadeau. Hits her first and drains her second. All inbound there by the Gaiters. Chamberlain on a quick break here. Claire Murphy brings it into the center. Back out to Le Gachard. Gachard has it down though. And stolen there by Nadeau. Beautiful little side, just in ball awareness there by Nadeau. Forlan has it down low to Genois. Genois tosses it up for two. Beautiful little spin move here underneath the basket.
Yeah, that's a tough cover for the Gaiters. When she gets on that low block, she's pretty much unstoppable down there.
She Demerland tosses up a difficult jumper and or a difficult bit of a layup there, but it looks to be called a foul on the foul, and she'll go to the top of the key.
Foul on Jobin.
Chamberlain at the top of the line here for free throws. Drains her first. Chamberlain, local first year from Sherbrooke, and she spent her CJEP time in the CJEP to Sherbrooke. Definitely a comfortable setting here in Lennox Hall for her.
Hayden switching it up with a little zone full court press after the foul shot. Laval, though, able to capitalize as Bishop not get back in transition very well.
Once again, we see Bishop struggling with the transitional D, and Laval is just able to cut right through it.
Yes, they were fortunate with an easy miss layup there by Laval, and actually got the ball back and caused a foul.
3:16 left to play in the first. We've seen a close matchup here as both teams look to be pretty equal in all aspects of the game. It will be 21-20 lead for Laval. It's a timeout called. And thank you once again. Thank you for joining us here on SSN Canada. We hope that you join us later on tonight at 8 o'clock for the men's game. As you've seen, the number 7th team in the country, Laval Rouge, take on your Bishop's men's Gaiters. It'll be an interesting matchup there, eh, Rob?
Yeah, that should be a tough one for these Gaiters, but I know they're still looking for their first winning conference play, and it's going to be tough to do it, but they got to start somewhere, and I think the guys are ready for a challenge tonight, and I really think they have a good chance of winning this game.
Both teams coming off of the winter break where they participated in two tournaments, one at Concordia and one at UCAN. The men's team went 1-for-3 in their play, while the women's went 0-for-3, unfortunately, and both opened up their second half seasonal play against UCAM last weekend as both teams dropped a decision in the men's game. A close matchup, as we saw. The men only hit one shot in the third quarter, though, which really led to their downfall, whereas UCAM really overpowered the Gaiters. And they just had a bit of a stronger offense in the women's game.
Yeah, that one really hurt, especially for the men's, because Laval's sitting in fourth place in their league, but they have 3 wins over Bishop, so Bishop needs some wins, and they need them in a hurry if they want to look at the playoff picture.
Gotcharl has it here for the Gaiters. Trafford goes down low. A hard foul. No foul call there, sorry. Looks to be Genoa. Great defense with the service. But Chamberlain hustles back and gets all ball on that one.
I know most people in the gym, I think, wanted a foul call down there for Trafford, but Genoa actually had good defensive position, and Trafford actually just ran into a good no-call, I think, by the referee there.
Definitely there. I think the fall of Trafford looked a lot harder than the actual contact was.
I agree.
Good defense here by Claire Murphy as she forces a foul call there actually against Murphy. As a good hustle there by Majore Ferland, the third-year sports major.
I know Murphy might be kicking herself after that foul. They had Bishop's had Laval trapped out in there in the corner with only 5 seconds left on the shot clock, but maybe a bit of a dumb foul there and allowed Laval for quick 2 shots because of the bonus.
Ferland hits her first. Ferland only measuring at 5'4", but she definitely uses all that 5'4 to her advantage. Definitely a quick player, and she uses her speed as well. Waugh carries it up for the Gaiters.
Looks like Laval's switching into a bit of a 2-3 zone here.
Another missed three there, but a good rebound by Shao of the
great hustle by Nick there to get the offensive rebound.
Coach Pernell barking out the orders there from the sideline. His wall goes down low off of the fingertips of Bailey Trafford, and that ball will roll out off of the valve.
That, those bounce passes through the zone are really tough when Jesse bounces the ball like that. It slows down all of its speed, and a lot of times get picked off.
Tough rebound or inbound there by the Gaiters. Once again, we see their transitional D suffer. Genoa misses the layup. Covered there by Jesse Waugh. Back over to Charles. Charles drives to the net. And a foul called there.
Great take by Nexi. He got popped pretty good there by... Sorry, I didn't know who they called a foul on. She's covering her number there. 15. There's a great example of Nick. 15 did not have the position that Genoa had on the previous play, and was therefore called for the foul by the refs.
No doubt about that, Robbie, as their feet were not planted, and that's what led to that foul. Charles misses both of those free throws there. The Gaiters are not looking too sharp from the free throw line so far tonight. Another great hustle play there by Chamberlain. The ball almost was picked and then recovered there. Charles takes the rebound and drives up the floor. And makes Stephanie Charles great momentum here. Wall tosses up the three and drains it from downtown. And there we see finally some of the three throw shots paying off.
Great play by Melanie Ulake. Oh, gosh, Charles there draws the top two defenders in that zone, leaving Jesse Wall wide open for a three. Clutch shot there to tie the game at 23 with about a minute and a half left to go in this half.
Could be Kia's, but we still see the Gaiters still struggling from a three-point range. We'll see if they can pick that up. Usually not one of the weaknesses of the Gaiters. The Gaiters are usually a pretty strong shooting team, Robbie. And it doesn't look to be that way tonight so far. Both teams have struggled, only putting 23 points up so far with a minute and a half left to go in the first half.
Yeah, it's definitely been a bit of a offensive struggle. The two teams' defenses are actually playing quite well. They're both switching it up between man and zone. I think that might have a little, might be having an effect on the score here. The girls, I think, sometimes are a little confused as to what offense to run, and the defense is having a desired effect. So I think the shots will start knocking down for both teams here, and we'll see a great close to this game.
It will be the timeout slowly comes down. We said 1:37 left to play here in the first. Jean-Vier checking into the game for the Gaiters. We inbound it here. Looks like Chamberlain will be the one to inbound it here for the Gaiters. Or sorry, it'll be number 9 for Rouge, or they'll be inbounding it. Marie-Michelle Genois. Genois inbounds it there to Ferland. Ferland drives up the court and back over to Genois. Showing a struggle just to make it over in time. Ball back to the far side. As Linnell Dion has it back to Genois. Out to the far side to Ferland. Ferland misses the three.
Gaiters are really doubling down on Genois in the post. They're daring Laval to beat them from the outside. So far, it hasn't hurt them yet. Hopefully, Laval doesn't start knocking down those outside shots.
Ball over there. Oh, will that Gottschall drive the hoop? But it's stuffed by Genois once again using her huge reach advantage. Out of the far side, just out of her reach of Genois, actually. Maybe a few inches too short on that one.
Yeah, I think that might be one of the only times she has been able to get at one of those balls. Just a little bit too high.
No doubt. 49 seconds to go here in the second quarter. Wah carries it over half.
It'd be great for the Gaiters to come in, score a basket or two before the end of the half, gain a little momentum, maybe go up to the half leading by two.
Shaw tosses up a three off the front rim and off of the hands of Majore Ferlin, and it will be a Gaiters ball with 33 seconds left.
Timeout called by Coach Pernot of the Gaiters, probably looking to draw up some sort of last-second shot here. Laval actually probably, assuming they get the defensive rebound, will get a shot for one more basket there with one more time for one more possession. Be interesting to see who wins the battle of this last 33 seconds to go up into the half.
Coach Linda Marquet will most likely be looking to establish a quick defense. Kind of guess what the Gaiters will be trying to put as their offense, their inbounding offense. But at the same time, she'll probably be probably putting a few plays together, a few ideas on what to do if they get the ball back.
Yeah, of course. They'll have some last-second play drawn out, but Laval's first priority is to get the ball, and then they'll go run their old friends from there. But you're on defense now. They need a big stop here going into the half, so I'm sure that's what she's spending most of her time on.
See the timeout come down in its last seconds. And the play will begin shortly. As we said, 33 seconds left here in the first half, second quarter of play. And it'll be Melanie Ouellette-Gauchard to toss it in for the Gaiters. Passes it down low to Wall. Wall with the dribble. Cuts in good defense here by Laval. Really strong pressure. Almost out of the hands of Jambé, but right back out to Wall. She drives up and misses. And an offensive foul called there against Wall. Nothing really seems to be going in her favor tonight, Robbie.
No, she had that one big three a couple possessions ago, but other than that, she has been struggling tonight. A couple uncharacteristic turnovers, a couple travel calls, one double dribble, and now the charge. I know she'll probably be pretty unhappy with her play, but she'll come out strong in the second half.
No shot clock needed. 15 seconds to go in the first half. Laval ball. See Claire Murphy checked into the game for a while. Strong defensive player. Ball goes down low. Tossed up, and a beautiful layup there. A few seconds remaining. And more poor clock management as Charles looked to see how much time it was, and by the time she did that, the clock had expired. The layup there for Laval was by Melody Linal-Dion. Just looked to be a bit of a quick dribble by Elise Jobin. It confused the Gators defense a bit, and we saw Linal Dion really have a lot of time underneath.
Yeah,
the rim.
She was able to break down the defender at the top. Claire Murphy just got beat, forced the Gaiters to help in a quick dish for a layup there. Good play there, last second play there by the Laval Rouge Aor to go up two into that half.
And that brings the score 25-23 for the Rouge Aor. We will be back in roughly 15 minutes to continue the second half of this first game of the doubleheader. Thank you very much for joining us here on SSN. And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the second half coverage here of the first game of the doubleheader between the Lady Gaiters and the women's Laval Rouge AOR basketball team. The score after two quarters at half is 25 Laval, 23 for the Gaiters. And Robbie, what's the tale of the tape really for the first half?
Well, actually, if you can believe it, Bishops is leading in rebounds 20-17. I know they're down two, that's okay, but I think that's what was probably one of their goals, to go and out rebound this team. They're playing at a definite size advantage, but their offensive rebound, they had 8-0 boards. That's huge, and if they want to win, they got to continue to rebound the basketball.
And right away, we see a quick shot put up by Caddy Germain, and that rolls off the hands of
Laval,
I believe, and so it'll be a throw-in here for the Gators. Chamberlain tosses in. Good pass to a wide open Godchild.
Another offensive rebound. That two here early for the Bishops Gators, starting keeping that trend from the first half.
Wall over to Chamberlain. Drives to the net, tosses up a layup, and grabs her own rebound, but stopped by about two Laval players. Good second effort, but just unable to go straight up with the ball. We'll get Laval covers here as Jobin misses her first shot of the second half. Law takes it down into Laval territory. Pass over to Germain. Down low to Trafford. Bailey Trafford tosses up and over the net, and a miss there. The Gaiters still looking to find their rhythm and shooting.
Yeah, and that's the size of Nado. They're giving the Gaiters problems. Nado's not letting them see the rim and forcing them to put up some tough shots.
Ball over to Linal Dion, and she misses a three. Recovered there by Wall. Wall just eating up the rebounds tonight. Back over to Chamberlain. She tosses up a three, and it's good.
Great start for Chamberlain. She had a nice knockdown three there. Another layup she almost had, so she's looking to be aggressive with it. And Gators need some scoring. Maybe look for Chamberlain to put some shots up.
Ball up there and missed by Linal Dion. Recovered by Wall. Back over to Chamberlain. Great little fake there. Off the backboard and missed. Chenoir recovers the ball, and great defense there by Wallace. She got back into the play and forced the ball out. And it will be Chenoir to throw it in here for Laval. Coach Pernod barking out the defense that he wants to see. As for Laval, drives into the Gators' end. Recovered there by Laval. Back out to the point for Grulot. Grulot drives down low. Holds on to possession. Great defense there, but an unfortunate call against Gabrielle Cote-Cahouette.
Another dumb foul there by the Gators. They had Gav had her exactly where she wanted her. Picked up her dribble. 3 seconds left on the shot clock and get a cheap reach in foul. Those just must drive the coaching staff crazy.
No need to reach in for the ball. She had her moving on the opposite direction. Genoa now has it underneath the net. She tosses it up and misses off the rim. Germain with the rebound. She drives down the court. Back over to Wall.